Hi guys, good day. It's me, Teacher MJ. Our topic for today class, it's all about relationship between angle pairs. So without further ado, let's do this topic. Now, if we talk about angle pairs, we have the adjacent angles, the vertical angles, the complementary angles, the supplementary angles, and the linear pairs. So in the first part of our video class, we'll be focusing on adjacent angles and vertical angles. On the next part of our video, we'll be focusing on complementary angles, supplementary angles, and the linear pairs. Once again, class, for the supplementary angles and the linear pairs, there are so many students so confused with this one. So we will explain that one, class, on the next part of our video, and I will just put the link on the description down below. All right, let's focus first in adjacent angles and vertical angles. Now, let's talk about adjacent angles. What are those adjacent angles? Adjacent angles are angles, are two angles that share a common vertex and ray or side and do not overlap. So let me just explain that one, class. Of course, we know an angle, right? An angle is formed by two rays with a common endpoint. Example, class, if we have ray AB, so this is ray AB, all right, this is point B, and we draw another ray, there would be ray AC, all right, this is point C. Once again, class, when you name the ray, you start at the endpoint, then going to that arrow. So we have ray AB, and then ray AC. Now, if we have two rays in which they have the same common endpoint, and this is what we call the vertex, this is vertex A, we can form an angle, right? This will be our angle. So, angle is formed by two rays with the common endpoint, and this endpoint is what we call the vertex. Now, if we draw another ray in this endpoint A, in this vertex A, we draw another ray. So, let me just draw another ray. And we can form another angle, right? Let me just label this one as point D. Once again, we draw another ray in which they have the same common vertex, that is A, and we can form another angle right here. Now, these two angles, class, are what we call the adjacent angles. Now, the adjacent angle, class, they have the same common vertex, that is A, and they share common side or common ray, that is ray AC. So that's what we call, class, the adjacent angles. I hope it's clear for you, class. Adjacent angle are two angles share common vertex. So this is the vertex, that is point A. And they share common side or common ray. So they share common side, that is ray AC. Therefore, we can say that angle BAC. So you can read that one angle CAB, that's okay. Or you can read that one angle BAC. So angle B. AC is adjacent to angle CAD, or you can read that one DAC. It's up to you, class. So we can read this one CAD. So let's read this one CAD. Alright, so those are adjacent angles. So how about this one, class? In this illustration, what are the adjacent angles? So let's put it right here. Adjacent angles. Alright, so adjacent angles. And on this right side, let's have not. Based on this illustration, class, what are those adjacent angles? Can we say that angle AEB is adjacent to BEC? Are those adjacent angles? Yep, that's correct, because they share common vertex, that is point E, and they share common side, that is ray EB. Once again, class, when you name the ray, it should be the endpoint going to that arrow. Ray EB. Alright, so they are adjacent angles. So we can say that ray or angle AEB, so angle AEB is adjacent to, or angle AEB and angle BEC are adjacent angles. Angle BEC. So this angle right here is adjacent to this angle. Alright, so what else, class? What are those adjacent angles? What else can you see, class, for this one, for this illustration? Can we say that angle BEC is adjacent to angle CED? Are those adjacent angles? Yup, that's correct. Why is that, sir? Yup, that's correct. Because they share common side, that is ray EC, and then they share common vertex, that is vertex E. So therefore, we can say that angle BEC, so you can read that one BEC or CEB, that's okay. It's up to you, class, which do you prefer. And then angle CED or DEC. C, E, then D. Alright, those are adjacent angles. So these are adjacent angles, and these will be the adjacent angles. Alright, so how about this one, class? What if I say this one? Right, let me give you another example, class. How about this one, class? Are these adjacent angles? What if I say angle A, EB, and angle CED? Are these adjacent angles? Can we call this one adjacent angles? Angle AEB and angle CED, are these adjacent angles? Nope, that's correct. It's not. Why is that, sir? Because they don't share common side. They share common vertex, that is vertex E, but they don't share common side. So the angles are too far away from each other, right? They don't share common side, so therefore, this angle AEB is not adjacent to angle CED. They are not adjacent angles. So it's not, so angle AEB and angle CED, those are not adjacent angles. Okay, they are not adjacent angles, class. How about this one, class? Let me give you another example. What do you mean by that does not overlap? So, do not overlap. What do you mean by that one, sir? Let me give you another example for that one, class. Now, if we say angle AEB, so angle AEB, is it adjacent to angle AEC, this one, class? Are these two angles are adjacent angles? Can we say that angle AEB is adjacent to angle AEC? Are these adjacent angles? Nope, it's not. That's correct. It's not adjacent angles. Why is that, sir? Because you overlap in this particular angle. They share common vertex, that is point E. Once again, this is the common vertex, that is point E. They share common vertex, that's correct. They share common side, that is ray EE. Once again, they share common side, that is ray EE. This side right here, they share common side. And they share common vertex, that is point E. And they share common side. But the angle, class, overlap. This particular angle A, EC, overlaps in this particular angle AEB. Once again, this AEC overlaps this particular angle AEB. So therefore, class, this is not and adjacent angles. These two angles are not adjacent angles because angle A, AC overlaps this particular angle AEB. Alright, so these are not adjacent angles. So, we can say that angle AEB is not adjacent to angle AEC because this angle AEC overlaps in this particular angle AEB. They share common vertex, they share common side, that is ray EA, but this angle AEC overlaps in this particular angle. So I hope it's clear for your class with regards to adjacent angles. Let me give you another example, class. That's one example. What if we say this one, illustration right here, right? If this is angle 1 and this will be angle 2. Are these adjacent angles? Are these adjacent angles? Nope, it's not. Why is that, sir? They share common vertex. That's correct. They share common vertex, but they don't share common side. Therefore, this is not an adjacent angle. So, angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent angles. Alright, so I hope it's clear for you, class, with regards to adjacent angles. If you have some questions with adjacent angles, go ahead, class. Feel free to leave a comment in the comment section down below because we will be answering that one. Alright, let's focus now in vertical angles. So, let me give you an example for vertical angles. Now, let's talk about vertical angles. What are those vertical angles? Vertical angles are angles across from each other formed by intersecting lines, and they're always congruent. So, let me just explain that one, class. If we have two lines intersect to each other, we can form an angle, right? Now, this angle right here is congruent to this angle. And this is what we call, class, vertical angles. Once again, vertical angles form by two intersecting lines and they're always congruent. Opposite angles, class, are congruent. Once again, this angle is congruent to this angle. Therefore, this angle will be congruent to this angle. So if this is 110 degrees, what would be the measure of this angle, class? That's correct. This is also 110 degrees because vertical angles are congruent. Just always remember that one, class. Two lines intersect to each other. They form vertical angles, and vertical angles are congruent. Opposite angles are congruent. So for number one, class, what would be the measure of this angle right here? Opposite of 140 degrees. That's correct. This is also 140 degrees. Because vertical angles are congruent. Opposite angles are congruent. Now, just in case, class, the teacher will ask for the measure of this one. What would be the measure of this one, class? This angle right here. Just in case, class, the teacher will ask for the measure of this angle right here. Now, to find the measure of this angle, class, always remember this one. If you have a straight line, you can form a straight angle, right? Now, a straight angle, it's always 180 degrees. Always remember that one, class. In a straight line, we have a straight angle, and a straight angle, this one right here, class. Okay, this angle right here, a straight angle, it's always 180 degrees. So, therefore, if this is 140 for this one, therefore, this one right here will be 40 degrees. So, this is 40 degrees. Now, opposite of this angle right here, this is also 40 degrees. That's it. That's your offset for number one. Just in case, class, the teacher will ask for all the angles, the measure of all angles. So, that's the thing that you need to remember, class. A straight angle is always 180 degrees. Alright, so if this is 100 degrees, what will be the other 100 degrees, class, for this particular angle? That's correct. This one right here is also 100 degrees. Opposite of this given angle is also 100 degrees. Now, what will be the measure of this angle right here? Once again, if you have a straight line, you have a straight angle. So, therefore, this is 100 degrees. And we know that the straight angle is 180. So, we just need to add 80 degrees, right? Because 80 plus 100, that would be 180. Once again, class, for a straight angle, it's always 180 degrees. So you can just simply subtract 180 minus 100. Of course, that would be 80 degrees. Alright, simply subtract 180 minus 100. Or you can add 80. So 80 plus 100, that would be 180. Therefore, this is 80 degrees. This is also 80 degrees. And you're done for number 2. All set for number 2. Easy, right? For this one, vertical angles. So just remember that one, because vertical angles always congruent. They're always congruent. Now for number 3, what are those vertical angles? Can we say 1 and 2? Are those vertical angles? Nope, it's not. So that would be 1 and angle 1 and angle 3. Those are vertical angles. What is this? That's correct, angle 2 and angle 4. Those are vertical angles. And you're all set, class, for vertical angles. Easy, right? For vertical angles. Alright, so I hope you learned something new today, class, with regards to adjacent angles and vertical angles. Once again, the next part of our video will be complementary angles, supplementary angles, and the linear pairs. And I will just put the link on the description down below. Feel free to see the video, class. So I hope you learned something new today. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. You share it to your friends and to your classmates so that we can help more students. Once again, this is Teacher MJ. You have a great day, class. Goodbye for now. Bye-bye.